Good day. I'm Noveline Brewster, Public Affairs Officer of the Central Bank of Barbados, and I'm delighted to have this conversation with Michelle Darlow. Today we're discussing understanding the foreign exchange fee. Michelle, welcome to this program in which we'll be discussing the newly implemented foreign exchange fee.
Thank you, Noveline. My pleasure to be here.
Share with us, what is the foreign exchange fee, the FXF as we'll be calling it?
Right. The foreign exchange fee is a new charge on foreign exchange purchases within the system. The charge is payable by customers executing these purchases and using foreign exchange, and is payable at the point of sale of the transaction.
And to what exactly would this new fee apply, Misha?
Well, the fee is intended to be broad-based, so it really applies to any form of foreign exchange purchase, whether in the form of cash, drafts, wire transfers. So if you are sending funds abroad, whether it be U.S. currency, sterling, any denomination of foreign currency, the charge will apply. In addition to that, in terms of credit card purchases, so when you use your credit card or debit card or even a travel card, which would be prepaid, once you're executing some form of foreign purchase, the fee would also apply.
Why is this fee being introduced, Misha?
So as you would recall, on May 30th of this year, the Minister of Finance and Economic Affairs, in his financial statement and budgetary proposal, would have introduced a fleet of new fiscal measures. The foreign exchange fee is one of those measures, intended not only to further expand the level of fiscal consolidation, but at the same time to protect and safeguard our holdings of foreign currency.
Michelle, there are two dates for the implementation of this fee. What are they, and why are we doing it in a phased basis?
Right. So the first date that is important is July 17th. And on that Monday, what will happen is that all transactions related to cash, all transactions in the form of foreign drafts, foreign wire transfers, will have the 2% foreign exchange fee applied to them. The other important date is September 1st, and that is when all card-related transactions will similarly attract the foreign exchange fee.
Yes, and just explain for us why the two different dates for implementation.
Well, in introducing and implementing the foreign exchange fee, we had different consultations with the foreign exchange dealers as well as other stakeholders in the market. And we felt it important to sensitize the public and educate them in terms of the form that the foreign exchange fee will take, what transactions it will be applied to, what type of exemptions will be built around the structure of the fee. So we wanted to afford these sort of 2 weeks in order to be able to achieve that. Also, by way of the card-related transactions now, the reality is that the commercial banks and the other players in the market need time to adjust their system. So you're talking about programming changes, testing, ensuring that everything is synchronized from our end as well as the processors of these card transactions. And we similarly wanted to ensure that everyone felt ready in terms of the implementation to allow for a smooth transition to the existence of the foreign exchange fee. And also from a more personal point of view, the central bank is a provider of FX as well. So we make provision when our staff travel and business to provide them with travel allowances. So there are also internal requirements on our end, and we wanted to ensure that everything was well positioned in order for us to carry out the mandate as administrator of the foreign exchange fee.
Understood. Always good to make sure all systems are up and ready to go. Explain how this fee will be calculated.
Right.
Michelle.
So this is an interesting one, one that we've already gotten quite a few questions about. So the 2% fee will be applied to the Barbados dollar value of your foreign currency transaction. So let's say, for example, you're purchasing 500 US in cash. I know, Noveline, you may be purchasing more, but we'll assume that is 500 in cash. And for that, you would normally pay $1,014.29. In this instance, the 2% fee will be applied to that $1,014.29. So you're talking about $20.29 in the foreign exchange fee that would be added to your bill, so that overall you're paying $1,034.58 for that US cash that you would be purchasing from your commercial bank.
So just to be clear, the calculation is done on the Barbadian value of the transaction.
Correct.
And not on the foreign currency.
Correct.
Amount.
And this is important because we want to ensure that customers can clearly see what they are paying by way of the foreign exchange fee versus the conversion rate for the transaction, so that there is clarity as to what is going to government versus what is being charged for the conversion of the foreign currency.
It's a very good point. So how will this be reflected on any receipt that I may get?
We've presented two options for entities that are collecting the foreign exchange fee. Either that it be included on the transaction statement or transaction record, so that you as a customer have clear sight of that segment of the transaction and the payable amount related to the fee.
And who pays this fee, Michelle?
So the fee is to be paid by the customer, so any resident or non-resident using FX in the system is required to pay the fee at the point in time where they are undertaking to purchase that foreign exchange or to use the foreign exchange.
I understand there are some exemptions. Who is exempt?
Once a party is using funds that are available on their foreign currency account, so let's say a good example is a company that is an international business and financial services company. Once that company is utilizing funds on their foreign currency account, the foreign exchange fee will not be applied. There are other exemptions that we've built into the system. So, for example, statutory corporations that would be servicing their debt obligations, or in the case of the Barbados National Oil Company Limited in procuring bulk purchases of petroleum, they will also be exempted. So there are various exemptions that have been built in, and we encourage you to go to our website to see the full range of those exemptions.
Help me to understand. Mm-hmm. If I am selling or converting foreign currency, does the fee apply to me? Or for instance, I know I have an uncle who gets his check every mm-hmm. month from London, his pension check. He has to cash it.
Right.
Does the fee apply then?
Right. Well, if you think about it, in that instance, you are really providing the system with foreign currency rather than extracting foreign currency out of the market. So by you being a provider of foreign currency, you will not be charged the foreign exchange fee, because our intent is not to disincentivize parties that want to make provision of foreign exchange to the market. So as such, the foreign exchange fee will not apply in that regard.
Similarly, I've traveled to the United States of America on holiday. I decided I'm going to be very prudent with how I spend my money, so I return with most of it, and I want to convert it to Barbadian dollars. Does the fee apply?
No. So similarly, you've been diligent in terms of providing your bank with foreign exchange, and as such, you will not be subject to the foreign exchange fee. So any cash or any wire transfer that you yourself receive from abroad will not bear the foreign exchange fee.
I want to take you back to the implementation, the phased implementation, and perhaps a question I would like you to address is the one in relation to the use of credit cards.
Right.
So is it that
only foreign exchange purchases and payments made after September 1st using my credit card will incur the fee? Or will purchases I make between now and the end of August that appear on my September bill incur the fee as well?
So the key thing there is the execution date of the transaction. So once the transaction is executed on September 1st or thereafter, the fee will be applied. For transactions on credit cards prior to that date, they will not attract the foreign exchange fee. And this will be across the banking system that this approach will be adopted, not only by the commercial banks as authorized foreign exchange dealers, but also any other foreign credit card providers, such as Cave Shepherd, for example.
You've used that term, authorized foreign exchange dealers. Give us some examples of these dealers.
So the authorized foreign exchange dealers are the institutions that the central bank has really approved in order to assist with the management and handling of foreign currency. And by so doing, they're allowed to hold a certain amount of foreign currency. In terms of the requirements and how that process goes, the entities that meet that criteria as authorized by the Foreign Exchange and Export Credit Department would be commercial banks, as well as some of our trust and finance companies, so Consolidated Finance and the like. But they're all authorized foreign exchange dealers, which again you can see the list of on our website.
I recently acquired a Cave Shepherd credit card. Will I be charged the fee if I were to use
most
my card?
Definitely, as long as the transaction is a foreign-related purchase or transaction. So if you were using that card in Cave Shepherd, let's say, to procure some item, it would not apply. But if you are using that card to pay for purchases on Amazon or any of the other foreign merchants where ultimately foreign exchange will be required for settlement, then yes, the foreign exchange fee would be applied.
Interesting. I make a purchase on Amazon, it is canceled. Am I entitled to a refund of my fee? And if so, how do I go about getting my refund?
So the simple answer is yes, you will be entitled to a refund. And how we have built that into the structure is that if that reversal happens within the month that your commercial bank is reporting to us, they can easily accommodate the refund, and that would be reflected on your next statement. Now, if the refund happens for whatever reason outside of the period where the commercial bank has reported and submitted the amount collected from you to us, we have made provision for the entities to basically offset that refund against their next submission, so that we have some fluidity in terms of the processing of the refunds and ensuring that there isn't any backlog in terms of how those would be processed.
So it's really the authorized dealer as a customer with whom I'll be interacting to make
Correct.
Sure I am refunded my fee.
And even though we do like to hear from you, we would prefer if you didn't call the central bank indicating that a refund is due, unless there is some problem that we need to attend to. Your first course of action is really to your respective foreign exchange dealer, credit card provider, or your money service provider in the case where there may have been a wire transfer that you sent overseas.
Michelle, I have made a foreign purchase. I prefer to be billed in Barbadian dollars. Does the fee apply? And if so, why would it apply?
Right. Well, the reality is that once you are transacting with a foreign merchant, even though you may select Barbados dollars as the currency type for your transaction, that merchant still has to be paid in foreign currency when your commercial bank goes to settle that transaction. And it is because of that even though the currency of execution may be Barbados dollars, given that the related settlement will still be in some form of foreign currency, as such, it will still attract the foreign exchange fee.
Does this fee impact any of my annual allowances, be it for travel, educational purposes?
Yeah. So over the years, we've issued various travel allowances and other type of limits in terms of use of foreign exchange. All of those will remain the same in terms of individuals' allocation for any given period. The only thing that changes here is in terms of the cost of the foreign currency that you're utilizing.
Okay, and as you said earlier, if I am buying 500 US, that's all I'll be buying Michelle, I will be paying about $20.29 more for that 500 US dollars.
Yeah.
Is this the first time that we've had such a fee in place?
Well, this is not uncharted waters for us, because we have had a form of a fee related to foreign remittances that would have existed up to 1996 when the said order was revoked. So the central bank has dealt with administering some form of fee related to foreign currency transactions in the past.
Michelle, tell us again why it is important that this fee, or why this fee rather, was implemented.
Right. Well, I think here is important to understand the bigger picture, because as I mentioned, this is one of a suite of measures that were introduced and designed to sort of change the trajectory in terms of our fiscal performance, and by extension, the level of financing that is required in order to carry the fiscal deficit. The extension to that is that it allows then for a means for us to better protect the stock of foreign exchange that we hold, and to ensure that across the board our macroeconomic positioning is much better.
Well said, Michelle. Thank you so much.
Thank
it
you.
Was a pleasure chatting
as well.
With you.
Yes. Great.
That was a conversation with Michelle Doyle-Low. Thanks again for viewing. As Michelle said, you can visit our website for any further information. Good day.